Hi. Welcome to the Artsy Knitter. My name is Tru, and this would be episode 1, my intro. If my voice sounds a little hoarse, it's because I've been getting over a cold, so forgive me. It'll sound better as the episodes go on. But I just wanted to do an intro video just to introduce myself to you, kind of get you warmed up into who I am and where my background is from, what I'm like, sort of thing. So on Ravelry, where the group will be as well, is called the Artful, the Artsy Knitter. And my Ravelry name is Tru-ly, so you can find me under Tru-ly, so T-R-U. D-O-L-L-Y, so Tru without an E, Dolly. And that'll become clearer as time goes on, like what that's about. I have notes. I'll try to, like, appear to be organized. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see how that works, how consistent that is. But I think it helps just to kind of know where I'm going. Okay. Me, I am Canadian. I am a mom of an 8-year-old. Her name is Ava, and she is now a new knitter. As of maybe a few months ago, I want to say, she'll pop up on the show a little bit with me. So look out for that. Yes, I'm going to try and keep the show PG so that other moms who want to have their kids kind of watch and learn, you know, in Little One's Corner. I think that might be her segment. Don't hold me to any of these segment names as I reveal them to you. I'm still, you know, we're in a work in progress. I am a Wippie. I am a work in progress. So, keep that in mind. The Artsy Knitter. The name is because part of the reason why I call the podcast that name is because I'm an artist. Through and through, most of my life, that has been a running thread throughout my life. My brother is even a full-time artist. I'm originally from Jamaica. I'm born and raised there. I went to high school there and then came here in my teens. Now, if you're wondering, oh my God, okay, what happened to the little accent? The accent. Sometimes it will come out if you hear me ranting and you know, upset. All right, talking about some kind of what you guys call shenanigans, what I may call artsy escapades. That might be what my shenanigans is called. My main passion in art, I am traditionally, I don't want to use the word trained because I have mentored, but like I have traditional art background as well, but my focus within art is photography. Now, knitting is another medium for me. I'm applying certain inspirations within art to what I do. I mean, the way I choose colors is because of my background. So, but I'm a photographer. That's what I do for a living. And I shoot fashion. I shoot fine art. And when I say fashion, I mean like I used to run a magazine based in Miami and here in Toronto. I shoot covers, so full-on fashion, and editorials. I love shooting people. I love dealing with the face. But I did editorials as well, full storylines, like 6 pages, that kind of thing. 6 to sometimes 10 pages, depends. But my fine art, there are fine art nudes. Nudes. Naked people. Girls and guys. Yeah. But other things too. I collage. So I even take my own photography and I collage it. I take found objects, old vintage magazines, things like that. I also do encaustic. And I'll tell you how I got into that. It connects with how I started knitting as well, or how I started knitting every day. And I love doing portraits. As I said, I love people's faces. And I'm a customizer as well. So that means I customize t-shirts, I customize bags, I customize Converse sneakers. 2011, I want to say, I had an exhibition here in Toronto in the Distillery District. And the show had Converse sneakers connected to it. I can get more into that if people are interested. You can always let me know on the boards. What I did basically is use inspiration from different designers like Alexander McQueen. Oh my God. Love Alexander McQueen. He is the late Alexander McQueen. I love, you know, I think it's Sarah. What she's doing is fantastic. So I'm still committed to the house. But I love Alexander McQueen. So I did shoes based on some of his pieces from his collections. So I use that as inspiration. I can always show, if people want to hear more about it, I'll show some of the shoes I've done. But yeah, it's the artsy part of me. So I'm eyeballs deep in art. And that's why it's called the video blog or podcast or vidcast. I don't know the difference. Maybe somebody can tell me. What is the difference in those names? It's called the Artsy Knitter because of that. So, fashion, as I mentioned, has been a part of my life for over a decade. And when I say a part of my life, I mean like my mom is an interior designer now, who's also a new knitter. I just taught her this past weekend. No. 2 weekends ago? No. She came to visit me like maybe 2 weeks ago. I don't know. I was like cleaning this house frantically, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, but I just started to knit, so I'm not sure how she's going to respond to it, how she's going to, you know, keep up with it and that kind of thing. But we'll see, and we'll try and encourage her. And I'll find out if she's okay with me saying, you know, her Ravelry name and all this stuff. And then you guys, I can cheer her on. But she started with sewing she worked for the Canadian Embassy in Jamaica, and a lot of the diplomats' wives and people in the community, and she sewed custom-made pieces. So she's extremely talented, and my dad is has creative as well, so I have creativity on both sides. My dad sculpted, he modeled, he was an athlete. But he ran a company for construction, like made special blocks because we build with cement bricks in Jamaica. And he's been an innovator and an inventor. And loves music, sang, played music. And in his last days, he did a lot of karaoke, but like almost like what you call like professional karaoke, because it was like every single week, kind of like what I do with my knit night. But, you know, like steadily going every week and like connecting. And like even when he died, they had like a tribute to him. All the regular singers are in the circuit, so to speak, sang only his songs, things like that. So creativity is on both sides of my family. I remember Elsa Clench, CNN style. Okay, raise your hands. Who remembers CNN style? Anybody? Raise your hand. Maybe your pinky? That pinky's crooked. No. Maybe. Somebody. Don't leave me hanging. Okay, right. Anyway, but if you know about CNN style, let me know, because I loved Elsa Clench. I thought she was so, like, you know, like, composed and, like, right, and with the accent and everything, and it was fantastic. And, yeah, I love accents. I love the British accent. Doesn't mean I do it extremely well. So if it agitates you, forgive me. You might have to deal with it just a little tiny bit. Sorry. Anyway, yeah, I've been in fashion on different levels as a designer assistant. I've done choreographed runway shows, dealt with models, show produced, that kind of thing, taught runway walking, things like that. So fashion and art through and through. When I pick my patterns, those are the things that influence me. So maybe I'll get into more about how I got into knitting. I was on a streetcar and a woman was sitting behind me. Like, I think I kind of knew, like, she was kind of knitting, but I was still kind of like, what's she doing? And she's like, are you trying to see what I'm doing? I was like, yeah, what's going on here? And, you know, like, she could have, like, not talked to me, you know. I think I had an afro at the time. I don't even know. I changed my hairstyles. She showed me on that streetcar how to knit, and I went home, and I kind of ran with it. And I want to say that's before my daughter was born. So my daughter was born in 2005. So I'm guessing somewhere between 2000-ish and 2005, somewhere there. But maybe 2003, because I remember knitting a scarf for my mother and my stepfather. They're married and they live in Halifax. And I gave it to her, and I think they were worn a little bit and then tossed to the side, because I haven't heard nor seen anything of them, like, in I don't know how long. And I think that discouraged me and I stopped knitting. Oh my God, everything's to be blamed on your mother. No, not everything's to be blamed on your mother. I'm just saying, that really hurt my feelings. Anyway. So I got into knitting that way. I got into crocheting, and then I just picked it back up again. And, I would say 2 years ago. Now, I started because I collect dolls. I know. Bear with me. I get that something about that for some people is a little bit like, oh, you're an adult. You collect dolls. You play with dolls. What is that about? It's about finding my inner child joy, okay? I have an 8-year-old. Now, get this. I was a tomboy. I was into Transformers before I was into dolls. I mean, I did a little bit, but yeah, whatever, okay? I have a super, super, super girly girl who's totally into dolls, and that's our thing. That's what we do, okay? So just like, yeah, okay, right? She's into dolls. Moving on, okay? So I started knitting again, and I was like, okay, I could go on Etsy and find a doll dress, which is like $22. That's like the price of something for my kid. Not doing it. No. So, I started knitting. So, I was going to my knit nights, and people were like, what is your child doing? Like, what are you knitting? Like, I'm knitting away on these little tiny things. And they're like, are you going to do grown folks things? And I'm like, yeah. Like, eventually. Like, don't pressure me. But anyway, so I got into it eventually. So, and then that progressed to what I call art days. And a fantastic woman who I bonded with at my knit night, the first knit night I started going to. Let's pull back. I've had a really hard year last year. And I really wanted my friendships to have I just wanted them to have substance, and I don't want to sit on a veranda and beep about boys and like, that's important and that needs to come out, but then I also want the conversation to turn into something interesting, like, here's what we're going to do about that, or, oh, you're starting a business, I have these ideas, do you want me to help you? Like, I want friendships that bond and pull you together and, like, inspire you and nurture Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't necessarily need someone to take on my stuff, so to speak. But I don't want to leave my hang times drained. I want to leave, you know, more creative. And so she and I started these things where we called them art days. And I would go to her house, and that's how, when I said I do encaustic, encaustic is wax painting. And so she started teaching me that because that's a skill she had, and I'd never done it before. She's also, like, super knitter. And so we'd spend the full day together, like, you know, from 10 in the morning till the evening. We would eat lunch, coffee, dinner, knit, and do these wax paintings. And then, of course, it became more and more about knitting the more obsessed I got. And that would have been last year, summer. So she got me into knitting every day. I knit every day. Didn't think that that would happen. But so I knit every day now. So, you know, and that's kind of part of my journey. And she took me under her wing. She, you know, gave me, gifted me yarn that I'm still knitting with, that I'm super grateful for. I mean, Boxing Day was the first time I'd ever actually built my own stash. So that's exciting. But that was powerful. You know, not even from a friend that I've known for a really long time. This is a friend who I really just started bonding with last year. And she was like, you know what? You've gone through a lot. Things are starting to change and shift under your feet. And so you need to keep your hands busy. And so I started knitting grown-up things, big things, human things, you know, not little doll things, and running out of yarn. And she gave me some stuff, and I got needles from her. My needle set is from her, and I'm really grateful. And those art days are great. I mean, I truly encourage people out there to have those times, even with your fellow knitters. Maybe split the day between something other than knitting, and then a little knitting, because it really nurtures you. I mean, granted, I'm the type of person that can spend lots of time, you know, I could see you every weekend or every 3 days. I don't even know how to say it. Every weekend. Not everybody's like that. So, you know, God bless her patience. But sometimes you have to pull back and let people do their thing, and they'll let you know when they want to hang out. But I say all that to say, I encourage you to have these art days within your community or with your best friends or new friends that you've met and are trying to bond with. It was, or is, I haven't done one in a while, so anyway, but I also spin. She taught me to spin, and I'm thinking of getting a trindle. Because I have to get her back her spinning stuff. You know what I'm saying? I love fiber. I did an encaustic piece with fiber in it. So when I say spinning was going to happen, spinning's going to happen. But it's very minor. Like, don't come to the podcast thinking I'm going to teach you anything about spinning at this point. Not that it's impossible, you know. You learn from small children. Like, I'll get back to that. Anyway, so I had a crazy year. These art days rescued me. One of the goals that I'm looking for with the podcast, with knitting, with Ravelry, the whole nine yards, I want there to be bonding with men and women, because I know that there are guys on there, on Ravelry. Like, I have seen a few, so, you know. But with a common hobby and just bond, and I want to go to festivals and meet people and, you know, like, have people come up and say hi and not be scared. Like, just because I have this shaved head, people, let me tell you, people say I'm intimidating. I'm assuming it's because I got a shaved head. I don't know. I'm really tall. I'm 5'10", and I'm curvy. And when I say curvy, I mean, like, let me phrase it. I'm busty and booty for my size in comparison to what I was 10 years ago. But anyway, so yeah, That's my goal, is to bond. And when I say bond, I mean I want a community. I love the idea of like somebody from Germany going, oh my God, I knitted that too, and this is what happened, and you have that problem, or somebody from Australia like, well, you know, if you could try the yarn that we have here for that, that might really work, or I shaved my head too, or I don't know, any whatever. Just I want to connect. I want to use it as a vehicle to connect. And to share the art side of me and how it influences my knitting, or how it could, or why I chose colors. And I'll show that when I'm going to get into some knitting stuff too, so don't worry. We're 20 minutes into this podcast. I am actually going to aim for 20 minutes with my podcast, 20 to 30. I know people are doing 40 minutes, an hour, and that's great. I love it. I need it. Don't stop. I'm just thinking that right now I'm going to kind of go with 30 for now. Let's see. Because I know you guys, I'm really grateful you've even taken the time to watch. So I don't, you know, I know you want to get to the next podcast that you need to catch up on. So, yeah. So, but yeah, I mean, I want that. I mean, think about it. Who remembers pen pals? Like, I had a pen pal from Japan. Like, the idea that a knitter from Japan is going to be like, oh, I have this pattern that's not on Ravelry that I saw on a blog, and you should look at this, and it's... I love Japanese culture. Like, I love, love Japanese culture, okay? So, that's, yeah. I mean, the dolls that I collect, they're Japanese and Korean. I grew up with Japanese things all around me, Korean, Chinese, like all kinds of things. So, and I might show you my dolls if you're interested. I know it's a little odd. I know that they're doll collectors on Ravelry too. So if you're interested, I could do a little segment at the end. I'll try to keep the important knitting, you know, like hardcore stuff at the beginning. And then if I wanted to go off on a tangent about art or something I'm making or painting or collaging or a shoot that I'm doing, I'll do it closer to the end so you can speed past it, because I've seen close friends, close knitters of mine get a little frustrated with podcasters who ramble on and on about the gum stuck to their shoe and how hard it was to clean the fridge yesterday, and I try to tell her that's all part of who they are, so, you know, but I'll try to keep that for you. You know exactly who I'm talking about. I'll try to keep my ramblings that have nothing to do with knitting to a minimum. You know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm, you, yeah. Anyways. So truly things that I'm mad about. As you can see, polka dots behind me. I love bow ties. You'll know. Yeah. You're going to see. I got bow ties up the wazoo. Okay. Hand tied bow ties at that, too. Let me fix this way. I got to get the orientation of the camera thing. And what I see is, yeah. Anyway, that's going to be interesting. I love bow ties. I love stripes. I love. Oh. Google this. Sandra Backlund, Backlund. That's a perfect example of how bizarre my brain goes when it comes to knitwear. Like, out there. Like, I know already. You're going to, that's not wearable, but it's artistic. And sometimes the Mona Lisa is not wearable, but it can inspire you to make something with those colors. So, truly mad about Italian Vogue, my fashion Bible. I'm not trying to be blasphemous. Sorry about that. I'm just saying, it's trying to accentuate what I mean. Italian Vogue, amazing. Nouveau, all that stuff afterwards. I love, love, love Alice in Wonderland. Like, I'm looking for Alice in Wonderland project bags, people, okay? I'm trying to, I found stitch markers. I'm so excited. I haven't bought them yet, but I'm excited. to collect those. So I love Alice in Wonderland, and I'll get more into how it's influencing me coming forward into my new shoots and things like that. I feel like I'm just gonna explode into my artistic life in a different way now, and I'm excited, and I think knitting has kind of rescued my heart a little bit, or my energy, and built me back up, you know. But I want to get to the things, so my knitting and stuff. So, pardon me. Oh, I don't know if you can see it. I love Paris, and no, I am not gonna be as fabulous as Molly from Homespun House with her different teacups and vintage. Though I have some, I only have two, okay? But yeah, this will probably be my cup. Anyway, I love Paris. I love Japanese dolls. I told you that already. I love Tim Burton, Strangeness. My daughter is knitting Rebecca Danger Monsters right now. I'm excited about this. My mom surprised us and gave us the book when we were in the bookstore. So she's stoked. I mean, she's doing Magic Loop already, and I just taught her to knit. So if you feel like you can't do Magic Loop, let me tell you, you can do it. You can do it. I can show you videos, yeah? Okay. Frida Kahlo. I will get into that later, how she rocked me. That courage, that boldness, I want to say the concentration of my knitting is in the last 2 years. I consider myself, or I've been told in some ways, pieces, whatever, whichever way you want to call it, I'm a bold, adventurous knitter. I am intermediate, but there's still things I haven't done, and things that I've already, like, whizzed through and repeated and so forth. But I want to hijack patterns. I'm like, could I just do that with the blah, blah, and change the and make a seat stitch because I hate ribbing and blah, blah. And people are just like, what? Why can't this, can't you just knit the pattern the way? Okay. Yeah, I got the look. All of that. They might not say it out their mouth, but the face is like, why can't you just, yeah, that's me. And so I will be talking about those things and asking for advice. And so part of that is I'm saying, even though I'm a bold knitter, and this is part of the hopes of the podcast, I have not been knitting 22 years, 2,200,000 years. So forgive me for that. But I do have opinions about the knits that I see out there. And think of it this way. It takes a village to raise a child. Think of me as your knitting child. A little bit. I say that to the veteran knitters who are like, mm-hmm. Ugh. If that frustrates you, that's okay too. You don't have to watch me. Just saying. You know, if you want to grow with me and stuff. Or whatever. Anyway, yeah, so my hopes are to show you, hijack patterns or things that I'm trying to hijack or might need advice on how to hijack, things like that, you know. But I was really nervous about doing this podcast because, you know, I am not the fat squirrel. Squirrel! Okay, can I just, wait. I'm just going to have a moment. I love the fat squirrel. Amy Beth is a freaking knitting rock star for me. Like, I love her energy. And I think I love her energy because there's a crazy in me that connects to a crazy in her. Like, watching her podcast. Like, when I first saw her podcast, I was like, whoa, that girl's out of control. But, which, you could be doing that right now to me. I don't know. But whatever. I love that she just got soul. Even when she talks, like certain words, things that she says, and I'm just like, where'd you get that from? I'm like, oh, I say that too. I'm like, oh, I can't say it on my podcast. And then people are gonna be like, you copy. Anyway, whatever. I'm not even going to worry about that. I decided. I've been putting it back and forth in my mind, asking advice, feeling like, oh, what if I don't have enough to say? What if I run out of things to say? If I run out of things to say, even though my boyfriend says I can talk with marbles in my mouth. If I run out of things to say, I'll just stop podcasting. How about that? You'll be okay, right? I think so. Because there's tons of great people podcasting. The Knit Girls, the Knit More Girls, the Stockinette Zombies. But my faithfuls, I watch The Fat Squirrel first. I watch Homespun House. I love Craft Stash. I mean, that girl's got style. She's got, like, hat things going on. I was like, what is she wearing today? So, yeah, I'll talk about that, too. I am not wearing a sweater that I've knitted, unfortunately. But it gives you an idea of the kind of things I like. See that? I've got, like, open zippers on the shoulder. And, like, you know, like, I like a fitted sweater with the, you know, zipper detail. Can you see that? That, for me, is mad cool. I hope I'm maybe inspiring some, you know, knitter out there right now to, like, add zippers to their designs or something. Sorry for the squeaking chair, pardon me. But, yeah. So, I love, you know, structure. I love texture. And I think that's why I got into knitting, too. Yeah. That's you'll find out more about me as I go through these podcasts. Yeah, I'm a little bit crazy sauce, according to Amy Beth. I'm sorry. I'm having a total knitting girl crush on Amy Beth. Like, not a dirty, just a knitting. Relax. Yeah, because I can know somebody right now, be like, ooh, you, what? Anyway, yeah, no. So, she's amazing. I think she's so funny. I think it's great that she's a mom. I think she, I love when she whispers. I don't care. Anyway, so, I have a Ravelry group. Changes will happen to it. Fingers crossed the banner that I put up will be the set banner, but I'm working on it. So one thing I wanted to talk about was, my, like, some of the sections I'm going to have, are things like Wippies. Those are my What's on the Needle Wippies. Whippies. That's my, like, section for, like, works in progress. I got Faux. Now, yeah. I'm like, I got Faux. Faux show. Like, when did rap, unless somebody has some other genre that they know of that comes from, become mainstream? It's like, oh my God. I love In a Snit. They're faux shows. I was like, what? No, she didn't. Yes, she did. I love it. It's great. Keep it up, girls. Do your thing. If you do not know what, okay, this is my intro video. If you're watching me and you do not know who the Fat Squirrel is, who Homespun House or In a Snit is, you need to work it out. I mean, part of the thing that made me hesitate, too, was, like, you know, I saw a podcaster who I still love, and don't, if you realize it was you, don't think I hate you. But she was just like, you know, she was generously going to share about podcasts that she likes and so forth, and or, like, oh, new podcast. She's like, yeah, because, you know, everyone's podcasting these days. I could have sworn I saw, like, a little roll of the eye. Almost, or just a toot, or something, I don't know. And I was like, I don't know if I want a podcast. But I was like, you know what? You either hate me or you love me, or you're indifferent, or you watch me or you don't. And it's okay. Totally okay. So I decided not to worry about it. I'm really reminding myself to go back to that place of just being excited about everything that I do and staying excited, because there's some podcasters that are kind of podcasting a little bit dry because they've been doing it a while. Oh God, they're going to hate me now. But if that's not you, then you just need to do. And if all of you are like, that's not me, then disregard what I said. So, moving on, my finished objects are going to be like, ta-da! So, and my artful escapades, otherwise known as shenanigans, from Amy Beth. The spotlight, I might be spotlighting different things, Little One's Corner when my daughter joins us. And, you know, like, artist profile, inspiration, things that are inspiring me to do other things, you know, things within knitting. And I'm knitting, and that segues into my first faux show. No, my first faux. My ta-da. While sick, when I say sick, I mean sick as a dog, cat, donkey. Sick. And I'm really good at fighting colds, but recently I've been really sick. And I still had, like, was on the internet, and I had a ta-da, like, what idea, bing. I stopped shooting fashion for a little bit because I was a little bit, I don't know if burnt out is the word, but... Do I want to get into this now? Yeah, I do. It's 37 minutes into the show. Okay, real quick, I had a, what you call like a Devil Wears Prada type person. Oh, let me not say that. She'll never see this video. Oh, well, I don't know. I only use that example because to say she is a strong individual, like outspoken, very opinionated, holds no fluff, which sometimes can hurt. And I'm told I can do that too, so I'm a little nervous about that with the podcast, but I'll try to keep it all, you know. Anyway, how do I make this shorter? I stopped for a little while because I really wanted to find my vision again. I felt like after going through a lot of evaluation with her, she didn't, I choose to believe she did not mean to leave me high and dry, but I didn't have a direction and I didn't know what to do. And I knew that there were things within the industry here that were not making me happy in terms of, like, I felt like I don't want to shoot just what people, you know, I want to shoot something with me in it or things that excite me. So I pulled back, pulled out, stopped watching fashion. I wasn't even watching Fashion Week. I wasn't going to Fashion Week here anymore, which I will again. And I just waited and meditated, and I do yoga and all that stuff. And, I mean, I meditated before this video. So anyway, I speed forward to say, I've had some new ideas, and so I started thinking to myself, I want that idea of being able to make things for my shoots. You know, that might mean knitting things for my shoots even. And so I made a piece. I don't know if this is going to show up because it is super neon. Can you see how neon pink this is? It's so neon that the screen is having... I think you can see it. I'm like, it changed the color of the screen. Let me see if I can put this on so you can see it. Chunky slouchy hat, yo! What? No, sorry. I'm having a little bit of an Amy Beth moment. But, I mean, I did this pattern myself. I mean, you could ride a bike in the city and you don't need a flashing thingy. This thing is so bright. But I want it for like a fashion thing. And so I made the pattern as I went on. But if you want something to kind of somewhat follow, try a pattern called... Sorry, that's my phone. Try a pattern called City Hat. That might work. Let me see if it's going to show up on here. City Hat? Yeah. There we go. By Kristen Spunkland. Spurkland. Okay, quick break. I'm really bad with spelling, so forgive me when you go into the groups and they reply and it's going to be a hot mess, and just work with me. I'm going to get better at that. I really need to get better at it, even for my daughter's sake. And pronunciations, if I pronounce your name wrong, please, you know, send me an email with it phonetically or just maybe forgive me, possibly. But yeah. So, this is a German yarn, and now I'm like, where did I put the label for this? I have the label for the other stuff already. Failure. I don't know if this is it. Could it be? Could it be? Yes. I cannot say that name. Schneckermeyer, I don't know. Bravo Big, that's what I'm gonna say. And this is the knee. It doesn't have a name in terms of the colorway, but I can tell you that the number that's here, I think, is 08234. I don't think you can miss it. It is the only neon, like 80s neon pink that they have. And it's 100% acrylic. I know. Don't get me wrong. There's a little bit of our yarn snobbish thing going on in me too. But sometimes a girl just got to make something out of the acrylic. You know what I'm saying? Because this is for a photo shoot. I mean, I'll wear it, but I'm just saying. Just bear with me here. Sometimes us moms are on a budget, and I will share tips for that too when I can. 200 grams, 131 yards of acrylic yarn. So that's what I made this hat with. Next ta-da is part of the Fat Squirrels Gratitude Cow. Been dying to knit something. I have tons more to add to that cow. But this is the Staghorn Mitts. Now, I've had problems with mitts. Let me just explain something to you why this is like a big deal. Why this is, I'm grateful knitting this thing. I had the strangest, smallest, it's going to sound funny, smallest, biggest hands. Longest, I have, okay, my wrists are 6 inches, here is 7. My longest finger, 3 inches long. Really, like, babies are like, when I do this, they're like, oh, wow, it's like spiders. Yeah, so I've had a couple problems with ill-fitting mitts that I made. I managed to do this and get it right. So I was knitting. I'm so grateful for these babies. You don't understand. So I'm going to leave those on. I am so grateful for them. I'm going to leave them on. So that was the Staghorn Mitts by Tera Johnson. Now, show notes, I'm thinking for right now, are going to be in when I put a post for the, like I put a thread for the episode into the group. I'll just put it there or I'll put it in YouTube. I'm not sure yet the blog situation. I probably will by the time this video goes up, but I'm just putting that as a kind of disclaimer. So it's a free pattern. Let's see if you can see it. Staghorn Mitts by Tera Johnson. Yeah, so it's a free pattern. And so is a city hat, by the way. And yeah, so I'm entering that into my gratitude cal. I have a couple more things too. And my hoe is a Stephen West pattern. No, really? We're like, really? Of course. Hello. Can I say uber fabulous? And now, I don't speak French. I'm learning. Like, un petit peu. I don't know. Not very good. Tripatite. I don't know. I call it the tri-vest because I can't say the name. I'm so sorry. Steven, I'm sorry. This is just the left side, the right side. I have to understand the orientation of this camera. Of the, there's the side, short rows. I did short rows, yo! So excited. So far, fantastic knit. And I'm doing, can I just tell you, pause for like, amazingness. Zen Yarn Garden. Oh, can I get this to focus? Serenity Silk Plus in the, I want to say, Garraby Hill. I don't know how to say it. But this yarn feels amazing. Like when I had to frog some of this stuff, I wasn't worried. I was like, oh, that means I just gotta knit it again. Knit some more. I get to touch it. It's so amazing. It's 75% superwash merino, 15% cashmere, and 10% silk. Oh, 500 yards. I think I only need two because I bought three, but I'm gonna exchange that for something else. I hate exchanging, but sometimes you gotta do it. yes, I use Lifelines. So the newbies that are watching this podcast, Lifelines are just that. They're amazing. Use them. Put them in. Take a needle, scrap yarn, put it in where you know, okay, I've checked the work. It's really good at this point. If I have to frog back, I only need to frog back to here or whatever. Put it in, trust me. I love the fact that the Ciao Goos have these little holes that you can just put it in there and just knit the lifeline in. That's phenomenal. That's one of the reasons why I love Ciao Goos. Am I saying that wrong? I don't know. I hear everybody say Ciao Goos, so. So, the colorway of this yarn is, it is green. It looks more blue on the computer, but greens and blues, I don't know. It's just beautiful. It feels amazing. So I'm going to knit the left side, the right side now. And I'll tell you how it works. I'll wear it the next time. Maybe even with a bow tie, different bow tie, whatever. But anyway, so that's everything for my first intro. I was going to talk about Spotlight, but I'll do that next week. I actually might do every other week right now. You know, I'll wait to see how the response. I don't know. Tell me if you guys have a serious problem. Does it throw you off if it's not there every week? If it's there every other week on time? Like, say, today's Saturday and I might be uploading either anywhere between tonight and Monday. Yeah, let me know. But, you know, join the group. I will be putting the feed to iTunes, so you'll be able to subscribe there. But I'll announce that in the group. Subscribe on YouTube. Thumbs up the video if you get a chance right now. Thumbs it up, y'all! There's a little button right there. Or maybe right there. No. Right there. Right there. I don't know. But yeah, so that's me. And yeah, tell me what you think. Have a great night. Thank you for spending some time with me. Thank you for taking the time to watch. And thank you in the future. Ciao for now. Tru-ly, signing out.